Welcome to Chronicles of Time Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury, but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies, and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. Whispers of the Enchanted Forest. Chapter 1. The Enchanted Forest. In the realm of Eldoria, where legends whispered through the winds and mysteries lurked in the shadows, there lay an ancient forest known to few but revered by all, the Enchanted Forest. It was a place where time seemed to stand still, where the trees spoke in hushed tones of forgotten tales, and mythical creatures roamed with a silent grace. Aiden, a hero of renown, with a heart brave and true, stood at the forest's edge, gazing into its depths with a mix of awe and resolve. Tales of a mysterious voice that haunted the nights within these woods had reached his ears, compelling him to uncover its source. The voice was said to be both hauntingly beautiful and deeply sorrowful, stirring the souls of those who heard it. As Aiden stepped into the forest, the air around him seemed to shift, the light filtering through the dense canopy casting a kaleidoscope of colors on the forest floor. The trees, ancient and towering, murmured softly as their leaves rustled in the gentle breeze, as if sharing secrets of old. The deeper Aiden ventured, the more alive the forest seemed. Flowers glowed with an ethereal light, and small woodland creatures watched curiously from their hiding spots. The forest was not just a place of beauty, it held a sense of magic, a palpable energy that resonated with Aiden's spirit. As night began to fall, the forest transformed. The glow of the moon cast a silver hue over everything, giving the woods an otherworldly appearance. It was then that the whispers grew louder, a chorus of voices that seemed to come from the very heart of the forest. Among these whispers, the mysterious voice emerged, its melody weaving through the trees, both enchanting and melancholic. Aiden followed the voice, drawn by its allure. His journey led him through hidden paths lined with moss-covered stones and over crystal-clear streams where the water sang its own song. The voice seemed to be leading him, guiding him deeper into the mysteries of the forest. Suddenly, a soft glow caught Aiden's attention. In a clearing ahead, bathed in moonlight, stood a majestic deer, its eyes holding the wisdom of the ages. Aiden approached cautiously, sensing a connection with this creature. The deer, unafraid, met his gaze, and in that moment, Aiden felt a profound sense of understanding pass between them. The deer led Aiden to a part of the forest he had never seen. Ancient ruins, overgrown with ivy and moss, lay before him, remnants of a time long past. It was here, amidst these ruins, that Aiden first encountered the creatures of myth, a group of ethereal beings, their features delicate and otherworldly, their presence both mesmerizing and intimidating. These were the elves of Eldoria, guardians of the forest, and keepers of its secrets. They spoke of the spectral wolf, a guardian of a timeless secret, and the source of the haunting voice. The wolf, they said, was bound to the forest, its fate intertwined with the mystery that Aiden sought to uncover. Finally, Aiden realized that his journey was more than a search for a mysterious voice. It was a quest that would unveil the forgotten history of Eldoria and the secrets that lay hidden within the heart of the Enchanted Forest. Chapter 2. The Elven Kingdom. As Aiden ventured deeper into the Enchanted Forest, the atmosphere thickened with ancient magic. The trees grew taller, their trunks wide and gnarled, their leaves whispering in a language as old as time. Sunlight filtered through the canopy in golden beams, casting the forest floor in a dappled dance of light and shadow. The deeper Aiden traveled, the more the forest revealed its hidden life. He noticed figures flitting through the trees, ethereal beings that watched him with curious, luminous eyes. These were the elves of the forest, guardians of its secrets and stewards of its magic. Aiden came upon a clearing where the trees formed a natural archway, leading to what appeared to be a hidden realm. As he stepped through, he found himself in the heart of the forgotten elven kingdom. It was a place of unparalleled beauty, with structures that seemed to have grown from the forest itself, their architecture harmonious with the natural surroundings. The elves, graceful and enigmatic, approached Aiden with caution. Their leader, a wise and ageless elf named Elandil, greeted Aiden. Elandil spoke of the spectral wolf, a guardian spirit of the forest, and the source of the mysterious voice that haunted the nights. The wolf was bound to an ancient secret, a tale of love and loss, betrayal and redemption. Elandil invited Aiden to their sacred hall, a magnificent structure beneath the largest tree in the kingdom. Here, Aiden was told the legend of the spectral wolf, once a noble creature that roamed the forest, its howl in harmony with the wind. However, a dark curse had befallen the wolf, binding it to the forest and turning its howl into a lament. Aiden learned that the key to uncovering the wolf's secret and breaking its curse lay in traversing the forest's most treacherous paths to find the three relics of the ancients, the crystal of moonlight, the feather of the wind, and the flame of the earth. These relics, once united at the wolf's resting place, had the power to release the wolf from its eternal sorrow. Resolved to aid the spectral wolf and uncover the depths of the forest's mystery, Aiden embarked on this perilous quest. He journeyed through whispering groves and over crystal-clear streams, his path fraught with challenges that tested his strength and wit. He encountered creatures of legend, talking animals, mischievous sprites, and beings whose existence was barely more than a wisp of smoke and shadow. Aiden's first destination was the Moonlit Grotto, where the Crystal of Moonlight was said to reside. He navigated through a labyrinth of caves, illuminated only by the faint glow of phosphorus and moss. In the deepest chamber of the grotto, he found the crystal, its light pure and serene. The journey to find the feather of the wind led Aiden to the highest peaks bordering the forest, where the wind spoke of ancient secrets. Here, amidst the clouds, he encountered a gray eagle, the guardian of the feather. Aiden proved his worth to the eagle through a test of courage and wisdom, earning the feather of the wind as a token of his bravery. The final relic, the flame of the earth, was hidden within the roots of the oldest tree in the forest. Aiden delved into the heart of the earth, where the roots intertwined with ancient stones. Here, he faced trials of endurance and strength, eventually uncovering the flame, a fire that burned eternally without consuming its surroundings. With all three relics in his possession, Aiden returned to the spectral wolf's resting place. The elves, along with creatures of the forest, gathered to witness the culmination of the quest. Aiden placed the relics around the wolf, and as they came together, a radiant light enveloped the clearing. The chapter concludes with the spectral wolf transforming into its true form, a majestic creature of light and shadow. The wolf's curse was broken, revealing the secret it guarded, an ancient elven heirloom, a symbol of the enduring bond between the forest and its inhabitants. Aiden's journey had not only freed the spectral wolf, but also brought healing to the forest and its denizens. Chapter 3. The Guardian's Tale. With the breaking of the spectral wolf's curse and the revelation of the ancient elven heirloom, the forest seemed to breathe a sigh of relief. The elves, in gratitude, invited Aiden to partake in a ceremony of ancient significance. As the sun dipped below the horizon, casting a golden hue over the forest, the elves gathered in a sacred glen, their faces alight with joy and relief. Elandil, the elven leader, began the ceremony with a tale that spanned centuries. He spoke of the spectral wolf, once a noble guardian of the forest, named Lirian. The wolf had been a protector of the elves, a bridge between their world and the untamed wilds of the forest. However, a dark force had sought to corrupt the balance of nature, casting a curse upon Lirian, trapping him in a spectral form and severing his connection with the forest. The tale wove through the ages, speaking of the elves' struggle to maintain the harmony of the forest amidst growing darkness. The ancient elven heirloom, now revealed by the lifting of Lirian's curse, was a key part of this history. It was an artifact of great power, capable of healing and protecting the land. As the story unfolded, Aiden learned of a looming threat, a darkness that had begun to seep back into the forest, an echo of the past that had cursed Lirian. This darkness sought to overwhelm the forest, to bend it to its will. The elves had long prepared for its return, but they needed a champion to stand with them. Aiden, moved by the tale and the plight of the forest and its inhabitants, pledged his support. He agreed to aid the elves in their fight against the encroaching darkness. In return, Elandil bestowed upon Aiden an elven cloak, woven with the magic of the forest, to protect him in the trials ahead. The following morning, Aiden set out with a band of elven warriors, led by Elandil's daughter, Lyanna. She was a skilled archer and tracker, her connection with the forest almost as deep as Lirian's had been. Together, they journeyed to the heart of the forest, where the darkness was said to be the strongest. Their path was fraught with challenges. Sinister creatures, twisted by the dark force, lurked in the shadows, attacking with ferocity. The forest itself seemed to resist their passage, its paths twisted and its obstacles formidable. In a clearing shrouded in an unnatural gloom, they encountered the source of the darkness, a corrupted tree, its roots spreading malice throughout the forest. The tree was guarded by a creature of shadow and malice, twisted reflection of Lirian's noble form. Aiden and the elves engaged in a fierce battle with the creature, their swords clashing against its shadowy form. Aiden, drawing upon the courage and strength he had gained in his journey, fought with a determination that inspired those around him. As the battle raged, Lyanna used her archery skills to target the corrupted tree, her arrows imbued with the light of the elven heirloom. With each strike, the tree's hold on the forest weakened. The chapter concludes with the final showdown as Aiden delivered a decisive blow to the shadow creature, dispelling it and breaking the corruption of the tree. Light returned to the forest, driving the darkness away and restoring its natural balance. The victory was celebrated by the elves and the creatures of the forest, with Aiden hailed as a hero. The spectral wolf, now in its true form, joined the celebration, its howls no longer of sorrow but of triumph and joy. Chapter 4. The Forest Secret. In the aftermath of the battle against the dark force, the enchanted forest began to heal. The air was fresher, the colors more vibrant, and the whispers of the trees were now of peace and gratitude. Aiden, standing amidst the elves and creatures of the forest, felt a sense of accomplishment, but he knew there was still a mystery left to uncover, the forest's secret. Elandil approached Aiden, his eyes reflecting a deep wisdom. "You have saved our forest," he said, "but there is one last task that awaits you." He led Aiden to a secluded part of the forest, where ancient ruins lay hidden beneath overgrown vines and foliage. "These ruins," Elandil explained, "are the remnants of an ancient civilization, one that lived in harmony with the forest. They were the original guardians of the secret you seek." As they explored the ruins, Aiden discovered carvings and relics that depicted a harmonious relationship between the forest and its inhabitants. The civilization had thrived through a deep understanding of nature and its cycles, and they had left behind a legacy of knowledge and wisdom. The secret of the forest, Elandil revealed, was an ancient tree known as the heartwood. This tree was the source of the forest's magic and life. It was deeply connected to the health and well-being of the forest and all who dwelled within it. "The heartwood is in danger," Elandil said gravely. "The recent darkness has weakened it. To save the forest, the heartwood must be healed." Aiden, along with a group of elves, set out to find the heartwood. Their journey took them through uncharted parts of the forest, where the magic was ancient and wild. The path was arduous, with obstacles that tested their strength and resolve. Finally, they reached a glade where the heartwood stood. It was an awe-inspiring sight, a colossal tree, its bark shimmering with a faint glow, its branches reaching towards the sky. But the tree was clearly in distress, its leaves were wilted, and its glow was dim. The elves gathered around the heartwood, their hands joined in a circle. Aiden, standing among them, felt a surge of energy as the elves began an ancient chant. The air around the tree shimmered with magic, and the heartwood began to respond, its glow slowly returning. As the ritual continued, Aiden felt a connection with the tree, a sense of understanding and unity. He realized that the heartwood did not just represent the life of the forest, but the interconnectedness of all life. The chapter concludes with the heartwood fully restored, its glow bright and strong. The forest rejoiced, its harmony restored. Aiden, having witnessed the depth of the forest's magic and the importance of preserving it, knew that his adventure in the enchanted forest had changed him forever. He bid farewell to the elves and the forest, carrying with him the knowledge and experiences of a world both ancient and wondrous. The story of the spectral wolf, the forgotten civilization, and the heartwood became a part of Aiden's legacy, a tale of adventure, bravery, and the enduring magic of nature.